Hi all, and welcome to Occult Melbourne, Part 6. First up, let's revisit the fountain in St. Patrick's Cathedral in Melbourne. So, I want to focus on this part of the first part of the fountain here. And as I've already done, I have likened it to the sephira here, the bottom sephira, the sephira of Malkuth on the Kabbalistic Tree of Life. Now, within the sephira here, we have earth, water, air, and fire, the four elements represented here as well. So on here, I just want to suggest that the structure is representative of the earth, the water, the air around it, and this middle part in here, the fire. So I just wanted to add that in. Here I'm showing two cauldrons, by the way. This one happens to be at the War Memorial in Melbourne, and this one at the War Memorial in Hyde Park, Sydney. So I've got a couple of other things to show you regarding this fountain, so let's keep going. The focus now I want to put on these three sections here. And they are perhaps divisions, as you will see. So they perhaps represent these divisions between the four worlds, the active world, the formative world, the creative world, and the archetypal world. Here is another view, and this view of the Kabbalah, of the Tree of Life, is perhaps more representative of the flow here. Of the fountain as it compares with the Tree of Life. So, and I'm suggesting that these three divisions here are these divisions here. So we'll just keep moving on. Here we have a Ptolemaic structure of the universe, if you will, from Claudius Ptolemy. So what I want to do is zero in on this and the fountain. So let's just move ahead here. So in this view, we can, down here, I've already likened this to the four elements, which are perhaps earth and water indicated in here. Then we have air, then we have fire. So that is represented here. And then as we move from the moon through to Saturn, we have through these seven plates here, or representing these seven spheres, well, they sort of go down this way, or we can see them in this view here. And then what I'm suggesting is that we have these three sort of regions here that are again represented here. So basically I'm not showing anything new here, but I'm just showing it as it compares with this particular map of the Ptolemaic universe, if you will. So let's just keep moving on. So in this view here, we can see Jeff Kennett up here for a start, the gargoyle of Jeff Kennett. Now he is actually, I've put this picture in here, but he is actually on this part of the church here. Because of the foliage, because of the tree here, we can't properly see the gargoyles. So I've just sort of put the pictures in here to show you them. We have the lion here and Jeff Kennett here. They look down on this fountain that we've been talking about, and this fountain sort of relates to, from what I can see, it relates to the holy science that is not really taught in the Catholic Church here. So the Catholic sort of followers and the people who attend this church would not be taught this, even though really it's actually their Bible's based on it, but yeah, they get told the literalist version of the Bible. But anyway, so Jeff Kennett is, from what I believe, Jeff Kennett has come out and said that he's not actually a Catholic. So it's interesting that he's on this particular church in the first place, being a Catholic church. But anyway, Jeff Kennett was the premier of Victoria. And on the Parliament buildings of Victoria, we have depictions here of, well, this is Mercury, which is Hermes, with his caduceus pointing to his pineal gland there. And we also have man here with the torch, with the flame of illumination, if you will. So But these relate to this. It's sort of all related. Anyway, let's keep moving on. You know, it's all hermetic. It relates to the holy science and so forth. So let's keep going. Aries. We'll just have a quick look at Aries. This is a depiction of Aries in Sydney, actually, with the sun rays coming out here. And this is part of an old bank motif. And this is in Martin Place in Sydney. And just moving on here, is we're in Melbourne, and we can see Aries the ram again, depicted on this motif on a bank. And we can see these shafts of wheat, and this is perhaps a representation of the sun here. Just having a little further look at this building here, the National Bank of Australasia Limited. So here we have a medallion designed by Freemason Rainer Hoff. So this is the reverse side here, and we have the skull of Aries, or Aries, represented here. And again, we have that shaft of wheat here. Interestingly, on this side, on the obverse, we have these power lines representative of electricity. So I'm just sort of likening this to the sun and to the electrical activity of the sun, if you will. So just remembering that Rainer Hoff is a Freemason. He has since passed away. So the Last Supper. Now this is not Melbourne, but I'm just going to put this in here quickly. Just an observation. So we have the red on this side and the blue on this side of the garments around Jesus there. It's by Leonardo da Vinci, of course, The Last Supper. They are perhaps representative of the left brain and the right brain. So you can see the colour there, pretty basic what I'm showing here. This is a mural. I took a photo of the paintwork inside the Orthodox Greek Church in Burwood, and we have the red bird here on this side, and we have the blue bird, both focusing on this part here, which is perhaps the pineal gland. This is from Disney, from Disneyland actually, the Cranium Command, show, and this part here reads, "The game for your whole brain," hint hint. Okay, so the using the whole brain. Okay, the conservatory. So the conservatory is here in Melbourne. This is the Fitzroy Gardens. So we'll just zero in on the, we'll start off at the front there. And out the front of the conservatory we have Diana and the hounds. So Diana is a goddess. We have the waters around the goddess. And this also perhaps represents an island in her case. And she is known as a hunter as well. And she holds the bow, representative of the moon in part, no doubt. Here we have a nice picture of the sun window here. And we also have these pillars, two pillars here, perhaps representative of Joachim and Boaz. So let's just move around to the other side. And we have another fountain here with these four circles. So within here we would have, excuse me, representation of the Vesica Pisces in part in here. And we have the checkered pattern for duality in here as well. On the building we have the these sun windows. And we have the pillars there as well. And this part here, the sort of skyline of the conservatory here, is perhaps representative of a sine wave also. We have little keystones here as well. So there's a close-up of the checkers. And there's a little boy wrestling a serpent there, or a snake, perhaps representative, the snake being representative of a state of mind, or perhaps a lower state of mind. Just moving on further. Here is a depiction of the sun windows here. The grounds of the University of Melbourne perhaps represent a sun window, with this part here being this part, and then we have the outline there. So I'm suggesting that that is a representation there of a sun window, and you can see the sort of lines radiating out here as well. Moving on. Now we'll just have a little look at this little thing here, which happens to be a sundial. So we'll just have a quick look at that. So here it is here. This part of the sundial is called the gnomon. G-N-O-M-O-N. The G-N-O would, relates to gnosis, to knowledge. And the M-O-N perhaps relates to moon, M-O-N, as in Monday. And the O-N perhaps relates to the sun. Anyway, so this is called a gnomon. We'll just have another look at it, another view. And we can see there that it's reading, what have we got there, 8, 9, 10, 11. It's giving us a time just after 11 a.m. The JFK Memorial. We'll just have a quick look at this. There's a little plaque. There it is there, the stone. And there it is there, sort of set in the park. Just to say that here is a serviceman sort of being stood off the back of the vehicle that John F. Kennedy is using to as he approaches the Dealey Plaza. And he was stood down, it seems, by this man here. And he's very surprised there with his arms out, and he actually does that three times. But we'll just move on from that. We don't need to go into that topic. Owls. Let's have a look at some owls. So just notice the sort of artistic style of this owl, and we'll just move on. This is by the Yarra River in Melbourne. Here we are at the Hyatt Hotel. This owl has a similar sort of style to it. There are two of them there. This picture here is from, this is an owl in Belconnen in Canberra. The perch of the owl and the style of the owl are extremely similar to these ones. Has to be the same artist, surely. Moving on. There's another, that's outside the Hyatt Hotel in Melbourne, another picture. Now we're moving into the park, the Queen Victoria Park or Gardens in Melbourne, and there's a little owl just here, so we'll just focus in on that. Just looking closer, the word wisdom is written here. So this is Queen Victoria here, I believe, and she is associated with the feminine quality of wisdom and philosophia. So we have the owl here. We'll just focus in on this a bit more, sitting on the books. So the owl has to do with wisdom and philosophy. So and yeah, and that's a good quality. But then we have this. We also have this sort of. Perhaps nefarious quality to the owl and worship of the owl as well, in the form of Moloch. And we have this at the Bohemian Grove in Northern California. With the cremation of care being a feminine quality once again. Okay, so we have sacrifice before the owl. So the owl perhaps has a feminine quality to it. So that'll do for part 6. I'll see you in part 7. Please rate the video and please comment if you've got anything interesting to say, or perhaps you just appreciate the video. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Bye for now.